Hello friends, welcome to EC Academy.
In this lecture, let us understand the problems on periodic and non-periodic signal. So here we have taken four different problems. So let us see one by one. Let us consider the first problem where they have given a signal, and for this signal we need to identify whether this signal is a periodic signal or a non-periodic signal. If we observe the waveform, the signal is repeating itself only between t is equal to minus 2 and t is equal to 2. The condition for a signal to be periodic is that the signal should repeat between t is equal to minus infinity and t is equal to infinity. So, if this condition is satisfied, only then the signal will be periodic. Since the given signal is repeating between t is equal to minus 2 to 2, the given signal is non-periodic. Now let us consider the second problem. Here we are considering a discrete time signal, and since this signal is repeating from minus infinity to infinity, t is equal to minus infinity and t is equal to infinity. Since you can see here, it is written in a dotted line, which means the signal is ranging from minus infinity to infinity. So we can say it is satisfying the first condition of periodicity. Now let us see if the signal is repeating itself for some particular intervals of time. The fundamental period of the discrete time signal is always identified by samples that can be written as n. So we need to find what is the value of n for this signal. So if we start from this point 0, we can identify from 0 to 1, 1 sample, 1 to 2, second sample, 2 to 3, third sample, 3 to 4, fourth sample. So which means for n is equal to 4, the signal is repeating again, which means for n is equal to 4, the signal is repeating itself. So the fundamental period of the given discrete time signal is n is equal to 4, and the signal is periodic signal. Now let us consider the third problem. Here x of t is equal to cos 2 pi t square. So it is same as cos square theta. This can be written as 1 by 2 into 1 plus cos 2 theta. If we compare the given problem with this equation, we can write that as 1 by 2 into 1 plus cos 4 pi t. So this can be written as 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos 4 pi t. Now in this equation, the first term is constant and the second term is a cos wave with amplitude 1 by 2. So this is a cos wave with amplitude 1 by 2. Always remember, a sine wave and a cos wave are always periodic signal. So this given equation is a periodic signal, and we need to find the fundamental period of the periodic signal. If we compare this equation with cos omega t, we can write omega is equal to 4 pi. We know omega is equal to 2 pi by t. So from this we can write t is equal to 2 pi by 4 pi. So if we take this ratio, we will get 0.5 seconds, which means the given signal is a periodic signal with the fundamental period 0.5 seconds. Now let us consider the fourth problem where they have given a discrete time signal. So here, always remember, the discrete time signal fundamental period should be equal to 2 pi into m by n. So the fundamental period of the discrete time signal should be always in this form. So if we compare this equation, we can write omega is equal to 2 pi. So we can write 2 pi in this form, and we can write that as into 1 by 1. So if we compare these two equation, we can write n is equal to 1. So the given signal is a periodic signal with fundamental period n is equal to 1. So we can write the given equation as a periodic signal. Now let us consider the signal x of n is equal to cos 2n. So here in this equation, if we take 2, this cannot be written in the form of 2 pi into m by n. So we can't write this equation in the form of 2 pi into m by n. So that's why the given signal is not a periodic signal. So we can write this signal as a non-periodic signal. So this is a non-periodic signal. On the same lines, try to solve few more problems. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.